American Legion Baseball. Shelby hosts Asheville Post 70. Good afternoon, Andy Foster, along with Dan Greer, and it's great to have you along this afternoon. A doubleheader. This is game one, and we'll have game two for you also this afternoon. Here's our national anthem.
What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Our national anthem at Veterans Phil Keter Stadium. This is the Cleveland Regional Medical Center pregame show. And Dan, the Suns pretty much basking the field at the moment, although there have been some clouds around today.
There have been some clouds around, but and some storms around in other areas of North Carolina. But right now we're in pretty good shape, it looks like. Hopefully we can keep that rain away. So let's take a look at our Forest City Honda starting lineups quickly. And first of all, Andy, give us the Asheville Post 70 starting lineups.
Here's the starting nine for Asheville this afternoon. Leading off, playing shortstop Jacob Cagle. Batting second, the second baseman Sam Wiedeye. Batting third, Tanner Smith, the catcher. And the cleanup slot is Christian Jukes, the center fielder. Batting fifth, Dylan Jones, the left fielder. Batting sixth is Nathan Blaylock, the first baseman. Kyle Ramsey, the third baseman, will bat seventh. Batting eighth, Casey Williams. He's batting for the pitcher, Jeff Hutchins. Williams of the DH. And batting ninth for Asheville Post 70, Dylan Williams, the right fielder.
And the Forest City Honda starting lineups for Shelby Post 82. Jackson Mims will lead off, play shortstop. Cody Finch will bat second and play second base. Nick Hastings, the right-hander out of Crest High School, on the mound tonight. He'll bat third. Phillip Black will be at third base and bat cleanup. Batting fifth is Jay Siegel, the right fielder. Batting sixth is Dustin Green, the left fielder. Batting seventh is first baseman Brock Melton. Batting eighth is Dustin Jones, the first baseman. Batting ninth is Caleb Burnham, the center fielder tonight for Post 82. And Andy, it's time to take a look at our Players to Watch, sponsored by Aura Supermarket and Broad River Hams. Who's your player to watch for Post 82?
I'm going to go tonight with Dustin Green, the left fielder, Dan.
And I'm going to go with Jackson Mims, the leadoff hitter, playing shortstop tonight for Shelby Post 82, coached, of course, by Mike Grayson. For our scoreboard again this year, sponsored by Medical Arts Pharmacy School Board. They've been doing this now for 20 years, thanks to the folks at Medical Arts Pharmacy School Board. They are located on Grover Street near the hospital in Shelby. I had a good breakfast there this morning. Always try the Hub restaurant over at Medical Arts. We're looking for breakfast or lunch Monday through Friday. And now with the play-by-play is Andy Foster. First of all, for Asheville, Jacob Cagle, Sam Wiedeye, and Tanner Smith up to the plate, Andy.
And the first pitch of the ball game from Hastings is high, ball one. Nick, the player of the year out of Crest High in the Big South Conference for 2013. The 1-0 is in there. Our home plate umpire, Dan, back again this afternoon, Brad Devine.
He was here for last night's game, here last night against Burke County.
1-1 from Hastings, breaking ball a little bit high, and it's 2-1.
Nick, the right-hander out of Crest on the mound. Nick was the player of the year in the Big South Conference this past high school season.
2-1 popped up down the first baseline and digging it out and making a great play is Dustin Jones. Jones comes up limping, however, after making that running catch up the first baseline.
Yeah, he went running up the first baseline, dives and catches it, and he may have just stumbled a little bit and hurt his ankle, but he's going to be okay. He's back in the catcher's box now.
Here's Sam Wiedei, the second baseman. And Wiedei is one of the veterans on this Asheville squad, Dan.
He is. He's been on there a couple years now.
Right-handed hitter. Asheville in their burgundy jerseys with the black sleeves and gray pants this afternoon. Burgundy caps. Hastings pitch is high, ball one. Shelby all white with the orange and blue trim today. One oh. Gets the outside corner. 1-1 to Wiedei.
This is a doubleheader, of course. Both games will be seven inning affairs this afternoon and evening here.
1-1. High.
Temperature 84 degrees here at game time with a lot of clouds, but a lot of sunshine also, Andy.
Pretty nice afternoon, although it's rather warm today. 2-1 is high, and it's 3-1 to Wiedei. It's been up in the upper 80s again today in Cleveland County, Dan.
It has another warm afternoon. It's summertime.
3-1, low ball four, one out walk issued to Wiedei. And here's Tanner Smith, the catcher.
A walk to Wiedei brings to the plate the catcher, number 5, Tanner Smith.
Smith, right-handed batter. The outfield, Dan, really shallow on Smith. And the pitch foul back into the screen, strike one.
You don't usually see the post 82 outfielders this shallow out in the outfield. They are tonight.
The 0-1 foul back in the screen, 0-2 now to Tanner Smith.
Now Coach Grayson was up in Asheville, I believe, Saturday night. Saw this team up in Hickory and saw this team play Hickory.
0-2, hard grounder foul near the coach's box left side.
And knowing Coach Grayson, he took some notes on each of these batters.
Yep, Shelby off Saturday night, and that gave Coach Grayson an opportunity to scout this Asheville and Hickory squad. 0-2 popped up right field, and it's going to drop in there. A base hit for Tanner Smith. Siegel couldn't quite get to it.
But the force play at second base is a threw it because Wiedei had to wait, see if he was going to be caught, and they just Siegel throws it second. It's a fourth play, and it's not a base hit. It's a fielder's choice.
No, that takes that base hit away, and it's also the second out as Wiedei was cut down at second. And here's a cleanup hitter, Christian Jukes, the center fielder. Another right-handed batter for post 70. 1-0 pitch, missed inside, 2-0 the count. That was an alert play by Jay Siegel and Wright to get that lead runner, Dan.
It was hitting that area right down the line a little bit. It was hard to get to by either first baseman, second baseman, or right fielder.
There's a chopper to third, and Black The force out on Smith at second, out three.
No runs, no hits, no errors, one left. After a half inning of play on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard, Asheville, nothing. Shelby, come to bat. And you're watching and listening to Post 82 Baseball on KTCBroadcasting.com.
Since 1983, Bill Shuford Heating and Air has been providing dependable service and quality products to Cleveland County and the surrounding area. And the tradition continues today with quality American Standard heating and air conditioning. Now you can get up to a $1,600 instant rebate or special financing terms through Wells Fargo or an American Standard extended warranty with a purchase of a qualified American Standard heating and cooling system. Bill Shuford Heating and Cooling, 213 Campbell Street in Shelby, your American Standard heating and air conditioning dealer, where your comfort is our concern.
Blanton Cars is slashing down payments. We offer down payments as low as $500. We are the most experienced buy-here, pay-here dealer in Cleveland County. We have cars as new as 2010 models that we will finance in-house. We don't look at your past credit. Your job is your credit here. We have payment plans to fit your budget. Stop by today and let us put you in the car you deserve. Blanton Cars has two locations to serve you in Shelby. East Dixon Boulevard, across from Super 8 Motel, and West Dixon Boulevard, next to Meineke Mufflers.
Since 1919, yes, 1919, Griffin Drugstore in downtown Kings Mountain has been serving the people of the Kings Mountain area with the finest in prescription service. And be sure to come in and ask about the 10% senior citizen discount. And most prescription cards are honored at Griffin Drug Center, 129 West Mountain Street in downtown Kings Mountain, since 1919. Open 9 to 6 Monday through Friday, 9 to 12 on Saturday. That's Griffin Drug Center in Kings Mountain.
Okay, back at Veterans Phil Keeter Stadium, bottom of the first inning. And it's no scores. We go to the bottom of the first for Post 82, bottom of the first. It's Jackson Mims, Cody Fitch, and Nick Hastings. As we mentioned, no score on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard after a half inning. Here's Jackson Mims. Jackson, last night, had two hits, including a double, and scored a run in that loss to Burke County. Pitches high from the starting pitcher for Asheville, Jeff Hutchins, ball one. The 1-0, line drive, foul ball, right side. 1-1 count. The 1-1 breaks in there in the count, 1-2. Jackson, Dan, continues to grow taller, it appears.
Yeah, it does. He had the two hits and that loss to Burke County last night and scored a run.
There's a liner back up the middle. Base hit for Jackson Mims. Leadoff single, bottom of the first inning. And the batter is second baseman Cody Fitch.
Single by Mims. Brings to the plate the second
baseman. Cody went hitless last night, so he's due to have a good game here tonight at the plate.
Now, Cody's had some big offensive games for Shelby so far this summer. He shows bunt, pitches outside, ball one. Game one of a doubleheader. Glad you joined us this afternoon on WOHS 1390AM.com. 1-0. Bunt attempt missed, or was it outside? 2-0 count. There's a bunt laid down to first. First baseman will step on the bag. Blaylock but the sacrifice is executed. Mims into second base. One out. Here's the pitcher, Nick Hastings. And with Mills at second base, Hastings a chance to help himself here. Nick bats from the left side, Andy. Should've got a couple left-handed hitters. I know Brock Melton, Nick Hastings. Is there another one in the starting lineup? I think that's it in the starting lineup. Hutchins checks the runner, comes to the plate, and the pitch is fouled out of play left side. Nick going to UNC, Chapel Hill this fall. And word is he would like to walk on to the baseball team down there. The 0-1, one outside, the count 1-1. And we hope Nick will walk on because he's an excellent baseball talent, Dan, as we mentioned, the Big South Player of the Year this season.
And he's got a former teammate on that team.
1-1 outside.
Mason McCombs, former Crest High player as well.
Mason was throwing that baseball 97 miles an hour during the college campaign. 2-1, fouled back left side. 2-2 count. Hutchins again checks the runner at second. The 2-2. Called strike three outside corner. Two outs. Here's the cleanup hitter, Phillip Black. Phillip, last night, was hitless. Hutchins with the pitch, it's low ball one. Pretty good breeze blowing now from left to right, Dan.
Yeah. There's the flag out in center field.
1-0 low, 2-0 the count.
Is stretched out for a moment there, but now it's drifting a little bit. But you know, Phil looks in good shape. Hopefully the rain will stay away tonight.
Two on the black. It's the outside corner.
You know, when that wind starts blowing from that direction, from sort of the northeast, that can mean rain at this time of year, Andy.
Yes.
Might be blowing a storm in.
2-1 pitch. Chopped to second. Throw to first in time to get Black. Four out three.
For Shelby, no runs, one hit, no errors, one left after an inning of play on the Medical Arts Hockey scoreboard. No score from Better Shield Keeper Stadium. You're listening to Post 82 Baseball on WOHS1390AM.com.
Remember, it wasn't raining when Noah started building the ark. For all of your waterproofing needs, stay high and dry with a call to H&H Pest Control and Waterproofing. H&H Pest Control and Waterproofing does all types of waterproofing, from basements to crawl spaces, from commercial to residential. Call 704-482-2847, 704-482-2847, for H&H Pest Control and Waterproofing, East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Know which midsize ATVs more Americans choose when they need an ATV that's built to work? Honda's 4-Track Ranchers. And the more you know about a rancher, the easier it is to see why. Like all Honda utility ATVs, they feature engines mounted front to back in the chassis. That means more power actually gets to the ground. There's a variety of rancher models to choose from, each with features that help make the task at hand much easier to tackle. Come on down to Honda of Shelby on Highway 74 Bypass East in Shelby and check out a 2013 Honda Rancher today.
Your number one choice for drain service in Cleveland County is Drain Cleaners of Shelby. From slow to clogged drains, to sewer odors, to moving or installing a drain, or even adding a drain, see Drain Cleaners of Shelby. With state-of-the-art inspection cameras, locating equipment, and high-pressure jetters, from residential to commercial, just call 1-800-440-CLOG for a free estimate. They'll make sure your drains are actually draining. That's Drain Cleaners of Shelby.
We go to the second inning. No score on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. Shelby and Asheville for Asheville. In the second, Dylan Jones. He'll be followed by Nathan Blaylock and Kyle Ramsey. And Jones fouls off the first pitch to the right side, strike one. Hastings with the 0-1. It's low.
Post 82 tomorrow night will be on Naroon up at, actually be back here tomorrow night against Hickory. Back here tomorrow night against Hickory.
1-1 pitch, hard ground ball in the third. Black's got it, throws him out, one down. Here's Nathan Blaylock, the first baseman.
Next batter will be the first baseman, number 27, Nathan Blaylock.
Then post 82 will be at Rutherford County on Wednesday night up at Nair Field in Forest City. And Andy and myself will be in Hickory on Thursday night when Shelby takes on Hickory at Hinkle Alley Field.
Fastball from Hastings in there. Strike one to Blaylock. Blaylock, left-handed batter. The 0-1. Foul back. 0-2 the count to Blaylock. That foul ball ricocheted back out onto the field, Dan.
It did. What did it ricochet off of?
It hurt, hit something down there. Yeah. I heard it clank.
It must be a rail or something in that way.
The 0-2 outside. 1-2 the count to Blaylock with one down, top of the second. This is a doubleheader today, so a seven-inning game, game one and two. 0-1 line foul over the dugout left side.
I think we're down to what, about 51 or 2 days until the World Series here, getting August 16th here at Veterans Field Keter Stadium.
The 0-2 swung on a miss, strike three. Blaylock went for one high out of the strike zone, two down.
And you'll be able to hear all 15 of the games of the World Series on our radio stations, WOHS, WCSL, and WLON.
Here's Kyle Ramsey, the third baseman, with two outs, nobody on. Hastings delivers, pitch inside.
Andy, I hadn't told you this yet, but you have been chosen as the sole play-by-play guy for the entire World Series.
Oh, is that correct?
We learned our lesson about that many years ago, didn't we?
Yeah. 1-0's in there, 1-1 to Ramsey. That is quite a feat if you do that.
Yeah, we did the state tournament that year, here in 2004, and it was no more after that.
1-1 swung on a miss, 1-2 to Ramsey. Of course, the state tournament in Wilson, the Southeast Regionals in Asheboro, and the series right here, so everything's in North Carolina this year.
And none of our North Carolina teams are going anywhere, out of state.
Yeah. 2-2 count down to Ramsey. Popped up right side. Brock Melton coming over. And he makes the catch.
Three down for Asheville here in the second inning. No runs, no hits, no errors. No one left on as we go to the bottom of the second. On the Medical Arts Office scoreboard, Shelby nothing, Asheville nothing, on
22 years. That's how long Lil Hardware and Garden Center has been serving you with the best selection of hardware, lawn and garden supplies, and a wide variety of dog and other animal foods. Owners Ed and Linda Lell thank you for your patronage and remind you that now's the time for the spring yard and garden projects. They have fertilizer, grass seed, pine needles, mulch, garden seed, and plants. And if you're planting your first garden, Lell Hardware has everything you need. Lell Hardware and Garden Center, Highway 18 between Shelby and Falston. As the spring season rolls in, remember Shelby Hardware for all the rental equipment you need to get those lawns and gardens in shape. Shelby Hardware's rental equipment includes blowers, string trimmers, vacuums, lawnmowers, aerators, spikers, spreaders, edgers, tillers, and ladders. And Shelby Hardware's small engine repair shop can service and repair all your lawn and garden equipment. Shelby Hardware, serving Cleveland County since 1979, located at 506 South Lafayette Street, Shelby.
Hutchins with the 1-2. Just missed outside. 2-2 count. Two on the way. Breaking ball. A little bit high. Full count to Melton with two down. Nobody on for Shelby. Bottom of the second inning with no score. Payoff pitch. Outside, ball four. Melton was behind 0-2 in the count and works a walk, Dan.
So a runner aboard with two out here in the bottom of the second inning. No score on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard.
Here's the catcher, Dustin Jones. Jones 1-for-3 last night. Hutchins' pitch gets the outside corner, strike one.
The 0-1 ground ball snagged by the pitcher flips it to first out three.
So for Post 82 in the bottom of the second inning, there were no runs, no hits, no errors, one left. And we go to the third inning on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. And we have no score, Shelby and Asheville on KTC Broadcasting.
Now you can get a free air filtration system with the installation of a complete heating and air system from Shelby Heating and Air, or get no interest financing at Shelby Heating and Air Conditioning. Coming now for all the details on a new Puron system with over 100% satisfaction guaranteed. Shelby Heating and Air Conditioning, your heating and cooling experts since 1977. Call 704-487-7877. Shelby Heating and Air, your factory authorized carrier dealer. Gigantic springtime savings await you when you buy your next vehicle at S&R Auto Sales in Shelby. Hurry in now and get down payments for as low as $699. That's right, only $699 for your down payment at S&R Auto Sales. And pick up this week's WhatsApp shopper for the S&R Auto Sales Sports Quiz. You could win a free $10 food certificate from the Clock Restaurant. Down payments, only $699. S&R Auto Sales, 417 South Post Road in Shelby, located right next to Bojangles.
Thomas & Howard Cash & Carry is Cleveland County's wholesale warehouse where you can enjoy the savings of buying in bulk. And yes, it's open to you, the public. Remember Thomas & Howard for your church socials, reunions, and family gatherings. They have cookout needs, including charcoal, hot dogs, hamburgers, whiting, and flounder. Plus, you'll find tobacco products, and all at low, low prices. See Tom, Maria, and Tanya at Thomas & Howard Cash & Carry, 1620 South DeKalb Street in Shelby, next to Ken and Mary's.
Asheville nothing, and for Asheville, top of the third inning, it's Casey Williams, the DH, Dylan Williams, right fielder, and then back to the top of the order, Jacob Cagle. Williams, right-handed batter, steps in to face Nick Hastings, the tall right-hander. Pitch is low, ball one. So far, Dan has kept his pitches low in this contest.
Keep it low and 105 eighth into the bullpen right side. Quite a few ground outs, in fact. He struck out one.
A lot of sunshine back at the park. 1-1 pitch. Big cut, swing and a miss. Strike two, 1-2 to Casey Williams.
At 84 degrees here this evening, you need to come in today. Every day you come in, you can see the progress on the guys of champions outside, don't you?
1-2 pitch, swing and a miss. Ball got away, but Jones throws him out on the put out, and one out.
They've made a lot of progress over the past couple of weeks on that, Andy.
Really have. Things are really shaping up well out there. You'll notice the changes when you come to the park. Here's Dylan Williams, right fielder. Hastings pitch line, left field. And he gets away from Green and to second base. Goes Dylan Williams.
And that'll be a base hit in the air.
First hit of the ball game for Asheville. An E7.
After the hit, back to the top of the order, here's Jacob Cagle. Cagle popped out to the catcher to lead off the ball game.
Hastings pitch, outside corner, strike one. Jackson Mims going to come in and have a room.
officer said Dustin was joined the ball at the mound. Now the Braves are off tonight. They'll be back in action tomorrow night in Kansas City. Mr. Royals, you can hear that on Big Country radio stations. That's the first trip for Atlanta to that new Kauffman Stadium in Kansas City. One count to the leadoff hitter, Cagle. And the pitch is outside. 1-1 count. St. Louis still got the best record in baseball. Yes, says Kevin. Does that mean anything right now? 1-1 pitch. High. Now come September, it means a lot more, you know. Some pretty good races going on in the major leagues.
Yeah, I tell you, St. Louis, consistency over the last few hours.
2-1, low and outside. 3-1 now to Jacob Cagle.
You know, they've changed managers. You know, Tommy La Russa retired a couple years ago. And, you know, they keep winning. They lost a little. That's a big first baseman they had, Kevin.
Ground ball back to the mound, and Hastings throws out Cagle. Holding at second is Dylan Williams, two outs.
The last two, you know, that's a lick. That's kept winning.
Well, that tells you they've got a great organization top to bottom of the St. Louis Cards. Here's Sam Redi, the second baseman. He grounded out, rather walked, and then was thrown out on the first play. At second, pitch in there, strike one.
Sam Ortiz playing for Boston tonight. He is batting right up as a DH for Red Sox.
All right, outside corner, 0-2 now to Redi. Two outs, Asheville with the runner at second, top of the third, no score on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. Arrow two to Redi. High.
How long can some of these DHs keep playing? I mean, he's 37 now and on the top runners in baseball.
You would think they could play to the early 40s if you just DH him. 1-2. Just missed inside.
He will hit one out in the first inning early night in Detroit. Detroit went on to win that game.
2-2 pitch, called strike three at the knees. That's it for Asheville. Top of the third. 3-3 down, there runs the Ritz Marais. Nobody left. We go now to the bottom of the third on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. Most current Post 82 base batters seen and listened to tonight on WRHS AM at 1390AM.com.
These days, it seems like many companies are more focused on making things cheaper by reducing quality, performance, and reliability, while at the same time increasing their bottom line at the expense of you, the consumer. This is not our philosophy. At SCAG, we are constantly looking for new and innovative ways to improve our products and deliver increased productivity. See the good selection of SCAG products, including Moore's, at Elliott Supply, your sales and service dealer for SCAG in Cleveland County. Elliott Supply, Highway 182 in Polkville. Norris Merchandise's beautiful furniture, with bedroom, living room, and dining room furniture by the famous brands. Norris Merchandise's hardware, everything from nuts and bolts to lawnmower blades. Norris Merchandise's Carhartt clothing, featuring Carhartt workwear, casual wear, and rugged outdoor wear. And Norris Merchandise's an archery shop, with a complete line of archery equipment and accessories. That's Norris Merchandise, 2011 South Lafayette Street, Shelby, online at norrismerchandise.com or on Facebook.
Hi, this is Woody Durham for Mark Dedman's Carolina Trophies in Shelby. Through the years, I've seen a lot of trophies and plaques, and none appear nicer than those which come from Mark Dedman's Carolina Trophies. Their guarantee is not just a guarantee, but a promise for courteous service, the absolute lowest price, quality products, on-time delivery, and most of all, your satisfaction. Awards for all occasions, plus rubber stamps and engraving. That's Mark Dedman's Carolina Trophies in Shelby.
Bottom of the third, Shelby nothing, Asheville nothing on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard for Post 82. Caleb Burnham at the plate, Jackson Mims and Cody Fitch, and the count 1-1 to Caleb Burnham, who got the start at center field this afternoon with Nick Hastings on the mound. 1-1 fouled off at the plate, 1-2 to Burnham.
Burnham played for Coach David Rines up at Burns High. Jeff Hutchins with the 1-2. High. 2-2 count to Burnham. Ground ball up the middle, snagged by the second baseman. He has no play. Throws it to first, but it's a hit for Caleb Burnham. For Shelby, that is their second hit. Here's Jackson Mims, the guy that has that other hit in the ballgame.
He went off the ball to first with that base hit.
Get back in that first inning when the third out was made.
Hutchins pitch, foul back, strike one. Mims coming out swinging. We talked about the height earlier of Jackson Mims. Got to be 6'4", maybe 6'5". Now,
he's getting taller and taller. At least 6'4", maybe.
The 0-1 grounded by the third baseman, by the shortstop into left field. Mims 2-for-2, and Shelby with runners first and second with nobody out.
I'm going to do a little bragging now. Jackson is my Oral Supermarket play to watch tonight. He's 2-for-2.
Good choice. He was mine last
night. Yeah, he was last night, yeah. You could, anybody in this lineup, really, you could pick as a player to watch on most nights.
Cody Fitch comes to the plate, has sacrifice bunt in the first. And he's showing bunt, fouls it off, strike one. So a scoreless ball game. Shelby trying to get something on the board. Bottom of the third inning.
You know, I knew I was feeling a breeze, and our producer, Mr. Kevin Hastings, has a fan on his end of our booth here. Okay.
That's
which one, yours upstairs?
One one pitch again. Showing bunt is signaling the pitch is in there, and it's 1-2.
Mitch and Kevin are producers tonight, and our camera people, Frank Morrow and Andre Bush.
One, two is low. 2-2 to Cody Fitch. Burnham at second. Mims at first with nobody out, bottom of the third.
Hutchins going to throw back to second, and back in time is Burnham.
There's some warm-up action in the Post 82 bullpen. A couple of hurlers down there.
2-2 low. Four count now to Cody Fitch. Hutchins with the payoff. Line foul, right side. Shelby back home tomorrow night to take on Rutherford County. 7 o'clock start. Again, the payoff to Fitch. Low ball, four bases are loaded. Here's the pitcher, Nick Hastings. And Coach Fowler's going to call Nick over, Dan.
And he's going to do that as the Asheville coach goes out to talk to his pitcher.
Right.
And we're going to take a 30-second timeout on KTC Broadcasting.
The free kids vitamin program is now underway at Falston Pharmacy. Now you get a 30-day supply of chewable multivitamins for every child's nutritional needs. Just come into the Falston Pharmacy and pick up a free bottle every 30 days. Parents must come in and sign each child up for a 30-day supply of free chewable multivitamins. Call Falston Pharmacy for all the details. That's Falston Pharmacy, Highway 18 in Falston. Get your free children's vitamins today.
All right, play back in. Hastings steps to the plate with the bases loaded. And there's a liner up the middle. Base hit. One run in. Two runs are in. And Shelby takes a 2-0 lead. Bottom of the third inning, Nick Hastings helping his own cause there with a 2-RBI single.
As Burnham and Nim scores, and going down to second to play is Cody Fitch.
Two RBI,
still nobody out.
To the plate, number 20, Philip Black.
Here's the cleanup hitter, Philip Black. Philip rolled out to second to end the first inning for Shelby. Hutchins with a pitch, and there's a bunt laid down by Black. Only play for Hutchins to first. Sacrifice executed by Philip Black. Fitch goes to third and Hastings to second.
Sacrifice by Black.
And with one out, here's Jay Siegel. Siegel went off the bottom of the second, flying out to center.
Yeah, had a big night last night with a couple of hits for Post 82 in Pittsburgh County.
Hutchins pitch, one outside, ball one. 2-0 Shelby, bottom of the third inning of this game one, seventh inning affair, a doubleheader today. 1-0, ripped, foul down the left field line. One from Hutchins. Popped up, shallow, left fielder coming in and makes a diving catch. That's Jones, and there are two outs. Jones had to come a long way in to make that play, Dan.
He did. There was no chance for Cody Fitch down in third for Shelby to score. No attempt because it's so short. Not 15, 20 feet out of the infield. Into the outfield grass.
Here's Nelson Green. He lined out to the pitcher in the second.
Hutchins' pitch, foul back, strike one.
Best of one of our players to watch tonight for Post 82. Sponsored by Aura Supermarket.
All 1 degree. Slow roller to first. First baseman Blaylock steps on the bag at first for the unassisted out. Out three.
So for Shelby, Post 82 picks up two runs on three hits, so a no errors and a couple left on. We go to the fourth inning on the Medical Rights Trophy scoreboard. Shelby leads us for 2-0. And we're listening to Post 82 Baseball on KTC Broadcasting.
New owner, new attitude. That's Forest City Honda, voted the best new car dealer in Rutherford County for the second straight year. And Forest City Honda's Greg Huntley has been named the best car salesperson for the second straight year. Plus, the Honda Dealers of the Carolinas has named the Forest City Honda Service Department the best in the Carolinas by a vote of its customers. Forest City Honda, ready to serve you with the best cars, best service, and the best salespeople. Forest City Honda, Daniel Road, Forest City.
Hospice of Cleveland County announces the opening of their Hospice Resale Store. The store is now open and features approximately 5,000 square feet of retail space. The store is managed by Angela Ballard-Jones and is located at 323 East Marion Street, right beside of Dollar General. Donations are currently being accepted. For more information, call Hospice of Cleveland County, 704-487-4677. The new Hospice Retail Store, now open at 323 East Marion Street in Shelby, right beside Dollar General.
The Factory is Shelby's home for family food and fun. Jam and J's features a pizza buffet with salad bar, plus there's a game room. Adult buffet is just $5.99. This price good all day, every day, no coupon needed. Buffet for ages 4 through 10, just $3.09, and ages 3 and under, free. Call for information on birthday parties at 704-600-6182. So come on in, locally owned and operated, Jam and J's Pizza Factory, 1011 Grove Street, behind the Golden Corral in Shelby.
We go to the fourth inning. Shelby has a 2-0 lead now over Asheville on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard for Asheville. It's Tanner Smith, Christian Jukes, and Dylan Jones, the 3, 4, and 5 hitters. Nick Hastings, pitch, high and inside, ball one.
Again, this is a 7-inning game. Both games tonight, 7-inning games.
One over Smith. Fastball one outside. 2-0 the count.
Now, other parts of the country, some region programs on the first round played 7-inning games.
That's correct. 2-0 is in the end. It's 2-1.
I think that was the case down in Alabama, was it? Down around Dothan?
Yes. 2-run fly ball, center field. Burnham comes in a couple steps, then backs up and makes a catch. One out. Here's the cleanup hitter, Christian Jukes. Jukes on by fielder's choice in the first.
Out of the number 8, Christian Jukes.
A couple of the fly balls we've had in this game, Dan, have just died out there.
Not going far tonight. Not much of a breeze, really.
Pitch outside to Jukes, ball one.
Three helmet to him.
1-0, fouled off, and it's 1-1. Nick Hastings ready to work. And the 1-1 low. Post on the tour, ready this week tomorrow night here at Veterans Showcase Stadium against Hickory at Rutherford County on Wednesday night. As a chopper to short, grabbed by Mims, and Jackson throws out Jukes. Two outs.
Next up will be number
20, Dylan Jones. Dylan Jones comes to the plate. Jones grabbed it out to third in the second.
Of course, this is the final week of the regular season break. Playoffs begin sometime next week. And then, first of all, just still got a bunch of division games to play between now and then.
Pitch outside to Jones, ball one. 1-0, popped up, out of play. Shelby's got a doubleheader scheduled next Monday, Dan.
That'll be up at Hillary County.
1-1, breaking ball low. 2-1 count.
I bet it'll wind up regular season. That's their last night of play the games.
2-1 outside corner in there. 2-2. Tots, nobody on for Asheville.
There's not really any room to schedule for any lane house right now.
2-2. High fly ball foul out of play. Left side out of the park. Into that foul ball graveyard, Dan.
Down on the left field side. Behind the ball club.
And the 2-2 foul back into the screen.
A lot of changes have been made to this park in the 37 years of its existence.
2-2 pitch. Liner left field. Gonna drop in there. Two out single for Dylan Jones.
Second hole of the night for Asheville.
There's nothing quite like the first baseman. He struck out swinging in the second. Hastings pitch, swing and miss, strike one. The 0-1. And there, I believe, and it's 0-2. Hastings pitch outside. 1-2 count. 1-2 is high. 2-2 now to Blaylock with two outs and Jones at first. 2-0 Shelby. Top of the fourth. Ground ball. One hopper to Mims. Good play by Jackson, who took it on a high hop for the first play on Jones out three.
And for Asheville, no runs, one hit, no runs, one left. We go to the bottom of the fourth with Post 82 leading Asheville, 2-0 on WRHS1390AM.com.
Super values because we value you.
You get super values because they value you at Keith's Carpet and Floor Covering on East Marion Street in Shelby. Let Keith and Cindy give you a free estimate on flooring for your home. From carpet to tile to hardwood to laminate and much more. Pay less and save more at Keith's Carpet and Floor Covering, 1162 East Marion Street in Shelby. Keith's Carpet and Floor Covering, they value you, and that's where you get super savings.
Super values because we value you.
The The round man, Oki Knipe, invites you into Oki's Tire and Service Center for all your tire and auto service needs. Oki gives you the best value in tires, both new and used tires, and they'll mount and balance your tires free. Come into Oki's Service Center for all your service needs, including radiator flush, brakes, tune-ups, oil changes, and state inspections. Serving Cleveland County since 1978. That's right, over 35 years. Oki's Tire and Service Center.